Right. Now, if you see the working with arrays, this is the first one we have it. If you see my things here, working with arrays, internally I created here how to work with 1D array, how to work with 2D arrays, how to work with 3D arrays, how to work with 4D arrays, so on. But majorly, we are going to work in our regular day-to-day life 90% of the times 1D and 2D arrays. Maybe 10% you may going for 3D arrays. I didn't get chance to work with the 4D array. 4D array onwards, the kind of data sets we don't have at this point of time. But we have the support of that one in the NumPy array. Let us go and try to see working with arrays. Generally, we'll use NumPy to store numbers. That meaning there is a possibility if you want to store some strings, you can go and you can store here. But our business requirement will force you to use only numbers. However, it can be used to store any collection of single data type values. That means all numbers means numbers I can store. All strings means I can store the strings. All booleans means I can store the booleans. All complex means I can store the complex. But not mix of these things. One integer, one float means not possible. One integer, one string means not possible. Either all should be integers, or all should be strings, or all should be booleans, something like that. All should be one data type. And NumPy is a powerful n-dimensional array object. Now we'll go and try to see how to create 1D array. 1D array is nothing but one column data. Like we have here a human height is the one column. That column data I want to record it. Let's say in my classroom, I have 10 members. I want to know, hey, what is the age of me? What is the age of you? What is the age of you? Like that, all the members' ages, I want to note it down. Then we will go for 1D array. In core Python, range function is equal to NumPy arrange function. Here you can notice only one difference. Arrange means nothing but A stands for array. A stands for array. That means range is producing output as list. Range is producing output as list. Whereas arrange is producing output as array. That is what the difference, what you're going to see it. So range function and arrange function, both are same functionality wise, but range function output is list, arrange function output is array. We are trying to import here NumPy as np. Then we are trying to understand what is the syntax of np.arrange function. Let us go and try to observe np.arrange function syntax. Exactly three arguments we have: start, stop, step. I hope this already explained in my level one of the training, core level of the Python. Now returns evenly spaced values within a given interval. And also it's saying clearly functionality wise, it's same as the built-in function called as range function. The arrange function is produces output as a nd array rather than list. Whereas range function is producing list as a output, but arrange function will produce as nd array as a output. Let us go and try to generate here, for example, np.arrange 3. So it is producing 0, 1, 2 as output. You can notice it is integer, so integer outcome is came. 3.0 we provided, it is a float, so we got here float outcomes. We given np.arrange 3 to 7, we given start is equal to 3, stop is equal to 7, step is equal to nothing. By default, step will take 1, so we got here 3, 4, 5, 6. We know start will be included in our result, stop will be excluded in our result. That is the reason 7 is not came into the result. And next we have here 372. That means start is equal to 3, stop is equal to 7, step is equal to 2. So each time 2 will be incremented. First we got the 3, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 means it is equal to stop, so that is not came into the result. Now I want to create, or I want to understand first what you mean by range function. Already we got chance to see this range function in level 1 of the training. So that also exactly has 3 arguments: start, stop, step. Suppose if you given range 4, that means you given stop. Start is by default will take as 0. Step by default will take as a 1. Range 4 means it is producing 0, 1, 2, 3. I hope already you are masters with range function. Now I want to create here 1D array with few elements. I am taking here 0 start with, stop with 12, and step by 2. Then it produces 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Now I am able to see this array, whatever we got it, number of dimensions means we are able to see it is one dimensional array. Only one dimensional array. Simple way of remembering is with how many brackets it is started? One bracket, right? One square bracket. One square bracket means as a thumb rule, we can say it is a 1D array. Two square brackets means as a thumb rule, we can say it's a 2D array as a thumb rule. Now a 1D array dot shape is equal to, we are saying as 6, because we have here 6 items are available. 6 items are available. Let us try to create one 1D array with separate requirement. We'll try to see it. What I want is 1D array, I want something like this, I want to store it. Something like this, I want to store it. Can you please help me how to create with these values 1D array, I want to create it. So we can go and we can import the package called as NumPy as np. Then we are trying to say as np, then we are saying as arrange function, we are going to use it. Arrange function, we are going to use it. And it has to start with what? 5. It has to end with what? 31. It has to increment by what? 5. Then we are going to get here something that we are giving the name as np underscore array. NumPy array, we are going to get it. NumPy spelling I written wrongly. Now we are able to see np array. The np array, whatever we have it, I would like to know what is the type of np array. Now we can see NumPy n-dimensional array. NumPy n-dimensional array. And I want to know np array has how many values, those all information. I can see whatever my requirement I given, I want to produce this same thing, I'm able to produce it. And how many items we have inside this? If you want to know that one, you can go and you can use our regular length, or you can go and you can use, we have one thing that is known as shape. The shape also going to give you how many items are available. Any of these things, you can use it. Now, I want to know how many dimensional array it is. If you want to know how many dimensional array, you can go and you can say dot number of dimensions. Now it is showing here one dimensional array. I said number of square brackets started, number of square brackets at the rate of starting, at the rate of starting is equal to number of dimensions. Number of dimensions. As a thumb rule, we can remember like that. Here, how many square brackets it is starting? 1. So how many dimensions it is? 1 dimension. As a thumb rule, we can remember it. Please create one dummy array, something like this, from your side.